You get underground, it's a whole city. The guys that work at the mine, typically they spend more time underground than they do at home. They're a family. A miner becomes a mine rescue volunteer because they have a deep passion for helping people.
Can you give me an assessment of the situation?
The victim's breathing. He's under SSR 90.
Mines are getting safer, but there's still risk.
We have a belief that all critical, all fatal accidents can be eliminated, but you have to be prepared to deal with an unfolding event.
We simulate smoke, fire, first aid emergencies. It's a whole day process to get underground, run a simulation, and then come back up to surface. With the VR experience that Ed and his team have built, we can run the emergency and see what the result is. It adds to the frequency of the training.
When they're in a real scenario and they are given those same conditions, they know what the answer is.
Your heart rate goes up, you're sweaty, you still feel that sense of accomplishment.
Scope 44, where are you?
We can't have fires in a mine to train somebody, but I have no problem setting the mine on fire in VR. People remember through experience.
Have 500 friends that are underground, being able to go back and get them out of the mine safely, that's what it's about.